everyone. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm starting off with a little bit of skincare before applying any makeup. So here I'm just cleansing my skin with the Equate micellar water. Next, I'm spraying my skin with the Fair's Witch Hazel Toner. And now going in with the Lush Honey Lip Scrub and my First Aid Beauty Lip Therapy. Lately, my skin has been extremely dry, so I'm going to be using my First Aid Beauty Repair Cream as my primer. Starting with my brows, I'm going in with the Stila Stay All Day Brow Gel that I've been using as a brow pomade. To carve out my brows and prime my eyes, I'm going to be using the MAC Painterly Paint Pot. And to clean up the top of the brows, I'm going in with Urban Decay's All Nighter Concealer in the shade Fair Neutral. Now I'm going to be going in with the Sundown Palette by C Color. And I'm going to be going in with the first shade to set the paint pot. Next, I'm going to be going with this matte purple shade, and I'm just going to be placing it on the outer and inner corner to create a halo effect. Also, I found this palette at Winners, and I think it might be a dupe for the Desert Dust palette. Maybe not in the quality, but definitely in the shade range. Here, I'm just softening the edges of the purple shadow with a clean, fluffy blending brush. Next, I'm going in with this light peach shade. I'm using this as a transition shade for the next color. Now, taking this vibrant orange on a small blending brush, I'm going to be blending this into the crease above the purple shade. I find that some of these shadows do lack in pigmentation, so I'm going back in with the purple on the inner and outer corners, as well as going back in with the vibrant orange into the crease. Now I'm going in with this purple shimmer. I initially tried applying it with my finger, but I had better payoff with a brush and a spritz of water. Now going in with that same orange that we used earlier, I'm going to be lining my lower lash line with a pencil brush and lining the outer to center with this dark red shade. Now I'm just going over the brow bone with the first shade we used. Now I'm just adding a small winged liner for a little bit of definition. Now going in with the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Foundation in the shade Shell Ivory and taking a stipple brush and just blending this into my skin. Now I'm going in with a damp beauty blender and just patting this into my skin for a more natural look. Taking the Too Faced Born This Way Multi-Use Sculpting Concealer in the shade Marshmallow, I'm just going to be applying this underneath my eyes, along the bridge of my nose, my cupid's bow, my chin, and along my jawline. And going in with a damp beauty blender again to just blend this out. Now taking the Makeup Forever Ultra HD Loose Setting Powder, I'm going to be baking underneath the eyes and along jawline. After baking for a few moments, I'm going to be wiping it away with the It's Bananas Setting Powder by Too Faced, as well as setting the rest of my face. Taking the Too Faced Chocolate Soleil Bronzer, I'm just going to be bronzing underneath my cheekbones, along my jawline, and along my hairline. I'm going to be taking this down the sides of my nose, as well as across the tip of my nose to contour. Now to add a flush of color, I'm taking the Benefit Hervana Box Blush, and I'm going to be applying this to the apples of my cheeks. For a subtle glow, I'm taking the Artist Couture Purple Dream Diamond Glow Powder and I'm applying this to the high points of my cheekbones. And finishing off this look with the original Fenty Beauty Gloss.
So this is the final look, guys. If you'd like to see more content, please like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!